Thomas's Christmas Party. Mrs. Kyndley lives in a cottage by the railway. Mrs. Kyndley loves trains and waves when they go by. Once when she was ill in bed, she saved Thomas from an accident. The Fat Controller sent her to Bournemouth to get well. Thomas and Toby missed her greatly and looked forward to welcoming her home again. Toby saw her first. Peep, 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 he whistled. There's Mrs. Kyndley, and happily rang his bell. His driver, fireman, and all the passengers waved to welcome her home. Thomas was pleased, too. His trains were heavy at Christmas time. I can't do it! I can't do it! He panted sometimes. But Mrs. Kyndley cheered him on. Oh, yes I can! He would puff bravely, forgetting the hard work. Thomas had never forgotten that she had saved her from an accident and always wanted to thank her properly. Toby agreed with him, and so did their drivers and firemen. Let's give her a party at Christmas, they said. Where can we hold it? They wondered.
Our shed's much too small. There's no room for anyone to fit when we're inside.
But Thomas's driver wouldn't give up. Let's try Tidmouth, he said. I'm sure the big engines would like a party in their grand new shed. We'll ask them when we go there tonight. The big engines were delighted, and so were their drivers and firemen. We'd like that, they said. A party will be fun. We'll ask the Fat Controller tomorrow.
A party for Mrs. Kyndley, said the Fat Controller. What a good idea of Thomas.
Let me see.
We've no trains on Christmas or Boxing Day. We all want Christmas at home, of course, so Boxing Day will be best.
So they made an invitation card.
Thomas, Toby, and friends, request the pleasure of the company of Mr. and Mrs. Kyndley at a party at the new engine shed, Tidmouth, on Boxing Day at 5 p.m. RSVP, Sir Topham Hatt, Wellsworth, Sodor.
Thomas and Toby were at the big engines in Tidmouth sheds for Christmas, while Annie, Clarabelle, and Henrietta joined the other coaches in theirs. They were looking forward to the party and were so warm and snug that they had quite forgotten the weather outside till the Fat Controller came bursting in.
The weather's changed, he called out. It's snowing hard at Farqua. Mr. and Mrs. Kyndley are cut off. We'll need snowplows to fetch them tomorrow.
What about it, Thomas? Asked the Fat Controller.
He knew Thomas hated snow. Thomas said bravely,
I'll try, sir. We must rescue them. We must.
Can I help, sir? Asked Toby.
That's a good engine, smiled the Fat Controller. You two will manage splendidly.
Early next morning, Thomas and Toby were both fitted with snowplows and arranged back-to-back with a van carrying workmen coupled between them. They charged the snow drifts fiercely. Sometimes they swept them aside, sometimes they stuck fast. When they stuck, they drew back so that men from the van could loosen the hard-packed snow. Then on they went again. It was hard and tiring work for everybody. But at the cutting near the cottage, they could go no further.
Look at that! Exclaimed Thomas's fireman. Peep, peep, peep! Here we are! Whistled Thomas.
The snow was so deep round the house that the answer came from an upstairs window.
Toot, toot, toot! So are we, came from behind the cottage.
That's Terence, said Thomas excitedly. He's come to help, too.
Sure enough, Terence also had a snowplow and was working hard to clear the road. The two parties met to make a plan. Terence's gang promised to clear the snow from around the house, while the railway gang dug a path from the house to the line. Meanwhile, at Tidmouth, Henrietta was being swept, dusted, and decorated as never before. She felt very proud of herself, and when she was ready, Percy, who also had been given a snowplow, took her to Ellsbridge to wait for Thomas and Toby. Presently, Thomas and Toby arrived. They had a good rest and a clean-up, then scampered up the line with Henrietta to fetch Mr. and Mrs. Kyndley, while Percy took the workmen back to Tidmouth in their van. It was dark when they finally reached Tidmouth. The shed doors were shut. There was dead silence, and no one was about.
Beep, 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 beep,
they whistled desperately. Where is everybody?
Suddenly, a chorus of whistles and cheers came from the shed. Lights in the yard flashed on, and the shed door slowly opened. Merry Christmas hung in colored lights out inside. Sir Topham and Lady had welcomed Mr. and Mrs. Kyndley, and everyone gave them three cheers. Mrs. Kyndley asked at once to see the engines.
We're honored, said Gordon, Henry, and Edward.
Then Mrs. Kyndley especially thanked the smaller engines.
Thomas and Toby are old friends, she said. And now, Percy, you are my friend too.
Percy was so pleased he bubbled over.
Three cheers for Mrs. Kyndley, he called. Peep, 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 they all whistled.
The Fat Controller held his ears, but everyone else laughed and joined in. Meanwhile, the Christmas tree had been rolled into position, ready for the carol singing to begin. They sang all their old favorites till their voices gave out, and then they were refreshed with hot coffee and mince pies. Then they pulled crackers and played games and had a perfectly splendid time till, all too soon, it was time for the party to end.
Ladies, gentlemen, and engines, boomed the Fat Controller. We are here to honor our gracious lady who last Christmas did our railway a great service. We all hope, Mrs. Kyndley, that you will accept this free travel pass over our railway. May you have a long life and good health to enjoy it.
Cheers followed, and to the strains of, For She's a Jolly Good Fellow, punctured by whistles, Sir Topham and Lady Hat took Mr. and Mrs. Kyndley away to stay at Wellsworth till the weather improved. The last guest left, and the doors of the shed were closed.
What a lovely party, said Edward.
Thank you, Thomas, Toby, and Percy.
And so say all of us, hummed Gordon.
But no one finished the song. Tired and happy, they were all fast asleep.